sorry we got cut off. Okay, here we are, beginning of the march. I want to bring you this view so you can see people, you can see your friends who are here. Obviously a permitted march. We'll be meeting a larger group at Iolani Palace. They're there now. We'll also later on be marching to the statue of King Kamehameha, which is in front of what is now the Supreme Court, and visiting also the statue of Queen Liliuokalani. At the state capitol, it is the opening day of the
Any mana, bro.
Population of Hawaiians have declined to 40,000 in the entire state, the entire nation. From an estimated 400,000 to 800,000 at the time of Captain Cook. A census of 1890. 1893 was the first. That's the 25th anniversary of the commemorating that moment. I got a couple questions that I'm supposed to clarify. One is I heard that the Hawaiian Civic Clubs told their people not to participate because it would be too. Populated by sovereign people. I'd like some clarification of that. Also, there is an official shirt for today. It's the black one. Very nice shirt. It was free. I want to know, before I put it on, I want to know who paid for it. I am wearing a red Kuki'ai Mauna shirt, because I know who paid for it. Me. Yes. Give me some info on that. Who paid for those shirts? Kim Coco.
How's it going?
Oh,
here. I got my
book. Kim Coco Iwamoto, who's running for lieutenant governor. You see, I'm also curious. Look at all those kids. See these kids? These kids know about the overthrow of 1893. Okay? They know that Hawaii was a constitutional monarchy recognized by foreign countries as an independent nation. We're nearing the end of the march. This group, we're going to be joining another contingent down the street at Iolani Palace. We're on Nu'uanu Boulevard, Nu'uanu Avenue right now. In Nu'uanu, which is also the venue for one of the biggest and bloodiest battles. Here we're gonna follow the end. We're gonna march down to Iolani Palace. I might cut out in my old live streams. I used to keep one take, keep it running for temporal context in case something happened. This is being well covered by live streamers, so times have changed. It makes it easier on me. And in the meantime, I have grown older. Aloha. Yeah. Thank you.
Aloha, Uncle Doug.
Thank you for being here. Alright.
Aloha, Lahuya Vai. Love you guys.
Alright.
To the last aloha, Aina.
Last aloha. I'll follow you down.
Head on, Uncle Doug.
Alright. That was good. I'm gonna head out now. Maybe we'll march a little ways here and then we'll start up again. Tag. People watching to see if they can see their friends and stuff. A lot of people here. I was keeping track of if there were any politicians in the crowd. There were a couple only. This is a little bit controversial, right? Kimiko Iwamoto, who's running for lieutenant governor, probably got my vote. It's there's some interesting people running for lieutenant governor. Also, Sherry Campagna, who is a Kanaka Maoli and running for Congress, CD2, Congressional District 2, against Tulsi Gabbard.
The best for last, what
a year. She's got my vote. She was also one of the organizers of the Women's March here in...
Aloha, Uncle.
Okay, you can see town here. We're going to be marching into downtown. It's a little bumpy. Hi, Linda. Yeah, the two politicians were Kimiko Iwamoto, candidate for lieutenant governor, probably got my vote. Sherry Campagna, who's running against Tulsi Gabbard in Congressional District 2, rural Oahu and the rest of the outer island. So far, that's all. We got some guts to come out here. Okay, so I'm gonna cut out here, and anything happens, I'll start up, and in any case, I'll start up at the next venue. I wanted you to see the march. Okay, thank you for following.